Hello everyone. Last class I explained how to draw ILD for RA, RB shear force and bending moment, and also solved one problem without any load. Okay, just we have considered the section at some particular distance and found the various ordinates for reactions, shear force and bending moment, and drawn the diagram. Today, what we'll do, I will take one single load and will show you how to find the maximum shear force and bending moment. Okay, let us see this problem. Draw an influence line for RA, RB shear force and bending moment at a section C located at a distance of 1 meter from the left end support of a simply supported beam AB of span 5 meter. Hence, find maximum shear force and bending moment at the section due to a point load of 50 kilonewton. Means here you have to draw influence lines for RA, RB shear force and bending moment. The section is located at a distance of 1 meter from the left end. It is given. Okay, so the span is 5 meter. Section is at a distance of 1 meter from A, and always to get the maximum shear force or bending moment, you have to place the load at the section. So here only one load, 50 kilonewton, so place at the section. Now what is the first step? First step, you have to find what is RARB. Already you know what is RA. RA is L minus Y divided by L, and RB is equal to Y divided by L. Now you know this, you can draw ILD for RA. So what you have to do, take RA. RA, to find ILD for RA, take RA. RA is equal to L minus Y divided by L. Consider at different points. First point is at A. At A, what is Y? Y is equal to 0, the moving load. And one thing you have to remember, here moving load I have shown, it is no need to show. You have to assume always in ILD problems, you have to assume one unit load, it is moving from A to B or B to A, any side. Okay, now this unit load is here between A and C. Okay, and now at A, the fine, what is Y? Y is equal to 0. So substitute in this equation, what happens? L is 5, 5 minus 0 divided by 5 is equal to 1. Next point is at C. At C, what is Y? Y is equal to this 1. So RA is equal to, again substitute in this, 5 minus 1 divided by 5. 4 divided by 5, that is equal to 0.8. Next point, at B. What is at B? Y reached here. I mean, unit load reached here. That is, Y is equal to 5. So, if you substitute in this equation, you will get 0. So, over, ILD for RA is done. Now, you draw the diagram. At A, the value is 1. At C, the value is 0.8. And at B, it is 0. So, join the points. So, you will get ILD for RA. Next, ILD for RB. What you have to take? RB is equal to Y divided by L. So, at different points, at point A, what is Y? Y is equal to 0. So, substitute in this equation, you will get 0. Next point, at C. What is at C? At C, Y is equal to 1. So, RB is equal to 1 divided by 5 is equal to 0.2. Next, at B. At B, full distance. So, Y is equal to 5. So, RB is equal to 5 divided by 5 equal to 1. So, transfer these points to here. At A, it is 0. At C, it is equal to 0.2. And at B, it is equal to 1. Join the points. So, you will get ILD for RB. Next, ILD for shear force. What you have to consider here, you have to consider the section. Section is already given here at a distance of 1 meter from A. Okay, at the section, you have two points. I mentioned in the last class also. So, first consider the left portion, that is the portion A and C. And next portion, right portion is C and B. So, let us consider first left portion AC. Okay, means unit load is now in between A, A and C. You have to imagine now, unit load is between A and C. What is shear force at X? I told yesterday in the last class what you consider where there is no unit load. That side you consider because always there will be only one term. So here there is no unit load. So I consider shear force at C is equal to minus RB, right side upward minus. So minus RB. What is RB? RB is equal to Y divided by L. So shear force at C, that's why I have written here VC is equal to minus Y by L. Next, consider at different points. At A, what is at A? Y is equal to 0. So VA is equal to, here it is at point A, that's why I have written VA. So 0 by 5 is equal to 0. Next point, at C, what is at C? Y is equal to 1. Substitute in this, you will get minus 0.2. Okay, left portion over. Now, unit load moved from A to C. Now, you have to consider this portion CB. Means, unit load is here now, not here. I have not shown that. You imagine unit load is here at a distance of Y from A. Okay, now consider the right portion. Means, assume unit load is in between C and B. Okay, C and B. So shear force at C. What I said, where there is unit load, don't consider that side. Now unit load is here, so consider this side. What is shear force at C now? RA, left side upward is positive, so is equal to RA. RA is equal to L minus Y divided by L. Then find at different points. It is already reached here. Now you have to consider C to B. So at C, what is Y? Y is equal to 1. So substitute in this, you will get 0.8. Next, at B, so full distance, that is Y is equal to 5. So VB is equal to 0. Now draw the diagram. So what you have to do, at A it is 0 and at C it is minus 0.2, so minus below the line. Then at C again, when you consider right side, at C is equal to 0.8, so plus 0.8, and then at B it is 0. So as I said, at the section you have both positive and negative value. So above the line is plus, below the line is minus. And also I said when you add this, you know, it should be equal to 1. Always like that. Wherever you add, no, it should be equal to 1. See here, 1. 0.8 plus 0.2 is equal to 1. Sorry, 1 plus 0, 1. 0.8 plus 0.2 is equal to 1. 0 plus 1, 1. But here shear force, only consider shear force diagram. So 0.8 plus 0.2 is equal to 1. Next, consider to draw ILD for bending moment. What you have to do? Same thing, you have to consider first left portion and means unit load is in between now A and C. Okay, here what you have to, moment means force into perpendicular distance. So unit load is this position. So I'll consider bending moment at C from this point. Okay, so bending moment at C is equal to now RB, it is upward direction moving. So that is RB into this distance, that is what, 4. So bending moment at C is equal to RB into 4. This RB into 4. What is RB? RB is equal to Y divided by L into 4. Now find at different points. First point is at A, Y is equal to 0. So substitute in this, you will get 0. Next point is at C, Y is equal to 1. So substitute, you will get Y is equal to 0.8. Left portion is done. Next, go to right portion. Means unit load is now in between C and B. It already reached till C. Now it is moving C to B. So here nothing. You imagine here there is unit load. Okay, so now what you have to find, bending moment at C. So unit load is here, I consider from this side. Okay, so bending moment at C is now RA into 1, this distance, RA into 1. So what is RA? RA is equal to L minus Y divided by L into 1. Now find at different points. First point is at C, Y is equal to 1, at C, Y is equal to 1. So substitute in this, so you will get L is 5 minus 1, divided by 5 into 1 is equal to 0.8. Next, at B, y is equal to full distance 5. So when you substitute 5 here, L minus 5, 5 minus 5 equal to 0. So now you got all the points, so draw the line. So what is at A? At A it is 0, then at C it is 0.8, left portion. Next, if you move to the right portion, at C again it is 0.8, and at B is equal to 0. At B is equal to 0. So draw the line. So I said in the last class, when you consider the bending moment, both left side or right side at the section, you have to get the same value. Okay. Now this is 0.8. So this is the first step you have to do for all the problems to draw the diagram. And this is standard diagram also. Now you have to find what is the effect of this 50 kilonewton. What I said in the last class, I said, to get maximum shear force, you have to multiply the load with the corresponding ordinates, correct? So now, so total shear force is equal to this 50 into, you have to refer shear force diagram because it is asked to find only what is shear force and bending moment. So refer this. How you can refer here? This is minus value, this is plus value. So at the section two values, you have to consider it separately. So 50 into 0.8, first one, that is equal to 40 kilonewton, that is positive, so positive shear force. Next, at the section, negative value also there, so 50 into minus 0.2, so that is equal to minus 10, that is negative shear force. And then bending moment at this bending moment, let's see, so 50 into 0.8, you have to refer bending moment diagram now. So maximum bending moment is 50 into 0.8, 40 kilonewton meter. So this is the way to find total shear force, total bending moment. So if the load is at the section, then you will have both positive and negative value. So you have to find maximum shear force, both positive as well as negative. So 50 into 0.8 positive, 50 into minus 0.2 negative. So then your bending moment is 50 into 0.8 only positive. So this is the way to find what is maximum shear force or bending moment using ILD. This is the example I have considered only single wheel load. So next we'll consider the next problem. I'll explain the next chapter. Thank you.